Welcome back, everybody. My name's A Prater54, aka Adam, coach of the McChesney Park Slowpokes, and today I bring you the draft analysis for Thrifty Tussle. This is a one of the leagues in TGR, aka the game room, that I have a really fun time playing in every time I'm here. But this is a little bit of shakeup. This is mid-tier and below. So this is open Terra preview. Basically, all six of your mons that come can Terra. You have to show your opponents what Terras you are at the team preview or before. And then the only thing after that is its item claws. And the only banned items are Razor Claw, King's Rock, Bright Powder, and Focus Band. But Bright Powder is a given because of Evasion Claws. But all in all, it's going to be interesting. But they did a new system. This is a sync draft, which means each round we put in priority of 1, 2, or 3. And we can wager 0 to 3 points extra to secure the pick. Say, for example, somebody bid on the same mon as you, and they only bid 2 extra, and you bid 3 extra. Well, now that it's a contested bid, because you bid 3, you get the mon, they don't. And then you pay the extra points. But if you are uncontested, which a lot of our rounds were, spoiler alert, we literally had 2 out of 10 rounds to where nothing happened and everybody was peaceful, which was absolutely hilarious. We were so close to perfect. But we get 65 points to do this with, and the scale goes from 10 all the way down to 1 for 10 Pokemon. So it's going to be incredibly interesting. So, I ended up for my first round putting like Iron Leaves, Mimikyu, and Slowbro Galar, and I ended up getting Iron Leaves for 10 points. So this is definitely going to be incredibly interesting. I finally got to have this Monastera. It's a shame that it's shiny locked though, but I can live with that. Don't think it would look much better chrome anyways. It might have the bundle effects where it just makes it look dull and plain. So we'll see how that goes. But Iron Leaves, being able to boost your speed and boost your attack easily is incredibly good. This even gets access to Swords Dance, moves like Quick Attack, Leaf Blade, Psy Blade, Close Combat, Sacred Sword to bypass defenses. I believe it even gets Calm Mind. I'd have to double check that. And like there is a, I think, a special set of this? 1 second. Now I'm curious. Yes, it gets Calm Mind, it can run Energy Ball, Focus Blast, can run Air Slash, Leaf Storm. Well, okay, so I can be physical or special. Interesting. I might actually have to look at that. What is my special attack? 70? But I have a monstrous 130 attack. Okay, that's interesting. So I have to run, if I want to boost your speed, I have to run 252 Jolly and 156 to 160 attack just to be able to do that. That's definitely interesting. Is it even physically possible to do a booster special attack? Let's find out. It is possible to do booster special attack. That is incredibly interesting to know about that mon. So if you do modest max special attack, you can have booster special, which is definitely interesting for that mon. So you can do speed special attack. You can do attack as well. That's definitely interesting for this. So this mon can do a lot. It even has Trailblaze. I believe it has agility as well, so it can set up, gets access to Double Edge as well. I can run Terra Normal and smack things in the face, Night Slash, gets access to wild shards. Oh, actually, it gets access to psychic terrain and whirlwind and workup too. That's definitely interesting. It's the first time I've actually taken a real look at this mon. But the fact that it can be physical or special is pretty good. I might have to do that one time. Just do Calm Mind Booster Special Attack and catch my opponent off guard. I look forward to that. That sounds like fun. But Iron Lee's was 10 points. And then I ended up second round getting Mimikyu. Because Mimikyu in low terror format in the right hands can be incredibly broken. Because a lot of things that wallet are gone. Most of the bulky steel types are gone, so Drain Punch can actually put in the finest of work on Mimikyu, being able to Trailblaze, have access to Wood Hammer, Will-O-Wisp, Thunder Wave, Trick Room, Trick, all very good. Access to Swords Dance, Shadow Sneak, Play Rough, and Shadow Claw, also very good. That and being able to Terra Fire in front of a steel type, be able to set up and smack things in the face. Absolutely beautiful. I love non-Terra Mimikyu, but I'm going to... It's either going to be a love-hate relationship between me... Some of these Sword Art Online songs are pretty loud. But Mimikyu can do whatever I need it to do, and does Mimikyu get anything to, can't remember, Mimikyu special setup? Did I lose workup? Yes, I lost workup, so Mimikyu has to rely on weakness policy in order to gain any form of special attack. That's kind of sad. But all in all, Mimikyu for 8 points is well worth the investment, and I look forward to using it again, especially now that I can actually Terra with it. Next, well, I got contested this round. I originally went for Mandibuzz, but somebody else did. This was the first of the contested rounds. I ended up getting my second pick, which was Araquanid. But yeah, that's not a bad loss, because now I get Sticky Webs, I get access to Terra Water Liquidation, Water Bubble, which is absolutely disgusting. I'm able to Terra into something that's a resist, offensive, be able to have coverage to where I can absolutely nuke something that wants to switch into me. I'll take it. Okay, Steel type wants to switch in front of me, I'm Terra Ground. What's your move, Kaiba? Not what I say, Yugi boy. So, yeah. This is definitely going to be interesting. Especially since this skin Terra. Like, this is going to be a... Because I did the Little Cup where the entire roster can Terra, and that was absolutely wild and fun. I predict this to be the same. But all in all, I really want to see what Araquanid can do as Terra and as support. So, we are going to hop on into the next one, and that's 7 points for Araquanid. Next, we got Hitmontop. Spoiler, I did what my usual is, and I only got one form of removal, because fuck wasting time on that. I know I don't sound like a draft league player, but if I give you the opportunity to spike, T-spike, or set rocks on me, I am not doing my job as a draft league player. I am not prepping well enough. The way my style works is I hit you hard enough to where you don't get the opportunity to do that. Unless you have a prankster mon. So, that's why I got Technician Hitmontop. Fake Out, Mach Punch, Bullet Punch, Sucker Punch. Gets access to Rapid Spin. Gets access to Triple Axel, which can be Terra Ice boosted. Absolutely amazing. Granted, my opponent can easily check me with a Terra Ghost Mon. That's fine. As long as I am able to hit it, it's all I care about. That's why Sucker Punch exists, so I can smack you in the face. I even get access to Thief and Agility. Alright, so you're trying to spin block me so I can't increase my speed. All agility. Okay, now I'm hitting you with a technician Terror Dark Thief. That's not gonna feel too fucking good. And once your ghost type's gone, I'm just gonna spin the hazards away. It's as simple as that. I'm like, you gotta do more than just block me. Because I will hit you in the face. Hitmontop was well worth the 7 points. And it's going to be a lot of fun having this thing with Terra. I'm going to say that a lot this draft. Next. Alright, for those of you that saw the last time I did singles where it was somewhat standard tier, I had a team that was missing 7 types. I did not have a ground type. I did not have an electric type, a bug type. I did not have a steel type, a dragon. I did not have a dark type. And I took the team to finals off of one mon. And one mon carried. Zangoose is back. Can I one up the 14 kills that it had the last time I had it as a Terra captain? There's only one way to find out. I almost had 2 weeks back-to-back where I had 6-0 sweeps on lead with this thing because I caught them off guard with Belly Drum and SD. And there's not much they can do about it. This being able to Terra Dark itself to avoid Prankster mons, absolutely amazing. Stopped mons like Morgrem, Sableye from burning it, phenomenally clutch. Being able to be Terra Fairy or Terra Ghost to block the fighting type moves, allowing you to set up. Amazing. But the piece de resistance is this gets Feint, this gets Fake Out, and this gets Facade. Terra Normal Toxic Boost Facade hits just as hard as Guts. It's insane. And you don't have to, like, always SD. You can just smack things in the face. And I look forward to just hitting things. Name of the game. Hit, hit, hit. And this is 6 points. You're probably looking at my team right now and like, oh, half your team's physical attackers. Do I like special attackers? No. My motto is, I prefer punching over screaming. But I make an exception. For 8 points, I ended up taking Toxtricity. This being able to Terra NF Punk Rock and access to Technician is beautiful. But the coup de grace is this gets Gunk Shot, this gets T-Spikes, this gets Shift Gear, a lot of the elemental punches, Drain Punch. I will be able to punch and glove and smack you in the face with a shift gear while Terra, allowing me to bypass all contact effects like Flame Body and Static once I Terra into a resist. Punch and glove is actually a very good item for this mon. Granted, I am times 4 weak to ground. And a lot of my team, well, doesn't. I kind of resist it, the end team. But I kind of don't. I'm kind of earthquake prone. But that's my style and I'm going to stick to it. Being able to scream at things and the addition of psychic noise is valuable on this mon. Preventing my opponent from healing, especially if it's a wish pasture or something with recover, just surprise it with psychic noise, like on a psychic type, is just ridiculous because now they're stuck. They can't recover. Absolutely amazing. I look forward to seeing what Toxtricity can do. And next, we hop on into my pretty much meme pick. I want to see if I can twinkle twinkle little star motherfuckers to the grave. Sorry I'm cussing, but Mignore makes me excited. It's not very professional that I am losing my profanity here, and I apologize to the children watching, but Mignore just makes me so damn hyper to have. And I'm sorry. being able to have all of its forms and have the shiny form, I can play Skittles Taste the Rainbow, and I love it. Minions are excellent. Shell Smasher can be physical or special. The shield's down ability prevents Toxic, Burn, I believe Taunt, and T-Wave from affecting me while my shield is up. Once my shields go down, though, I am prone to all those moves, so I am able to Shell Smash freely. Granted, my opponent could run Mirror Herb, and I can get reverse swept by anything that is faster than me, because this is base 60 while it's in its shell, and base 120 speed while it's out with 60 defenses compared to its 120 defenses in its shield. We will see how it goes. But all in all, Minyar is going to be a really fun mon, and I feel like it's well worth the 9 points. So, with that being said, we are going to hop on into the last 3 mons of the draft. Here's where it got a little meme-y, because I was like, oh, I don't have a fire or dark type. Why not get both? Let's get a mon that has Sludge Bomb, Flamethrower, Dark Pulse, Nasty Plot, gets access to come up and Sucker Punch to pick things off, gets access to Destiny Bond at base 95 speed. Okay, you got a ground type in front of me. I know you're going to try and nuke me, Destiny Bond. Come with me to the Shadow Realm. If I have to, I will pull the trigger. I don't care. This is my Reckless Abandonment mon. It's so frail that I don't care if I sacrifice myself to take you with me. This is going to be a fun mon. It hits harder than people think, especially after a Nasty Plot. But if you're able to get the Nasty Plot off at plus Terra and a defensive Terra that also hits the opponent super effective, this thing can just reverse. And I believe it gets Trailblaze as well. I'd have to double check that. It does get Trailblaze. Does it get Agility as well? Nope. But it can Flame Charge and it can Trailblaze. Interesting. Oh, and this is one of the few mons that still gets access to Toxic that is not a Poison type. Which is incredibly interesting. And this gets access to Counter. Counter is very, very hard to find this gen. So is the move Torment. Which I don't mind. I hate ads. But this being able to just do everything I need it to is absolutely amazing. Be both physical and special. Do I get access to Sword Stance as well? No, I do not. But I do get access to Roar, which means I can phase people out. But that is Houndoom for 6 points. At this point in the draft, I have 4 points left. And somebody was asking me, you're kind of missing a ground type. And I was debating on if I even wanted one. So, I got Mudspray! Baby Stamina Abuse, let's go. We can have Eevee Light Iron Defense with Trailblaze, being able to smack you in the face with Body Press. Turn it into Terra Water, Terra Grass, and just start sponging things in the face. Free Stamina Boost. I'll take it. This gets access to Roar, this gets access to Stealth Rocks, this gets access to Counter as well. So I can be a little tank that sponges physical hits and then blasts you in the face. Say you turn into it, I can counter the damage into the incoming mon, which is pretty damn good. This also gets access to Close Combat, Heavy Slam, gets access to Smackdown to ground mons so they cannot click Rooster or Magnet Rise anymore. Definitely, well, quite a bit it can do. This even gets access to superpower. Gets access to rest sleep talk, high horsepower, double edge, and access to body slam. And stab AQ is never bad. I look forward to seeing what this mon can do for 3 points. But here's where we get to the exciting part. At the end of the draft, I had 1 point, and I decided it's a tough choice. Do I take Piplup, who I have a plushie of, or do I get another baby water? Tragically, I ended up taking Froakie, because Froakie gives me spikes and T-spikes, and the protein ability is not bad. For having base 62 special attack and 71 speed for a baby is actually pretty damn good. You still get access to Grass Knot, Hydro Pump, Ice Beam, access to Trailblaze, U-Turn, still get Switcheroo, still gets access to Rock Slide and Liquidation, as well as Acrobatics. Being able to use Protein to change your typing is pretty good. You even get access to U-Turn. The flop out, this mon also gets counter. All in all, it's a funny little mon that could. Granted, it does not get Sludge Wave or Gunk Shot like Greninja does, but we can make do with Terra Poison. We'll figure it out. That and this mon, little baby gets Taunt, as well as Rain Dance and Snowscape. If I ever need to change the weather. All in all, it's going to be a fun little guy. I at least want to spike stack a little bit. Maybe get at most 3 to 5 kills with it if I can. Same with Mudspray. It's a goal of mine. So we will see how that goes. Then having access to Quick Attack. And to be able to pick stuff off if it's like on 1 HP is kind of funny. And I look forward to doing that. All in all, that is the team. Like and subscribe if you haven't. Tell me what you think of the team down below. And you guys have a good night. I'll catch you later. Peace.